Welcome to WatchGuard's Daily Security Byte. I'm Corey Nachreiner. Today's story is Apple's Spectre patch. If you watched last week's videos, you probably remember my Meltdown and Spectre video where I talked about two big vulnerabilities that affected Intel, AMD, and ARM processors. But today, Apple released three security updates, one for Apple OS X, one for iOS, and one for Safari. And all of these updates, among other things, include fixes for the Spectre vulnerability. Now, because Google actually had found these vulnerabilities quite a while ago in June, and vendors have been patching behind the scenes, Apple had already released updates that fixed the Meltdown vulnerability in many of their affected OSs. But these three updates all contained additional fixes for the Spectre vulnerability. Now, if you remember, the Spectre vulnerability is one that's a little less impactful and a little harder to exploit, but also that's one that's harder to patch. It's less impactful because it only allows one application to gain access to memory of another application rather than the entire kernel memory. In any case, Apple's updates fix some of the residual Spectre issues that affected their operating systems. Now, there hasn't been a ton of other Meltdown and Spectre updates. However, one of Apple's patches, the Safari patch, does highlight one kind of new Spectre update. In my previous video, I mentioned that a local attacker has to execute code in order to exploit these vulnerabilities. Well, according to Apple, an attacker can also exploit Spectre specifically through a browser by leveraging JavaScript. So the Safari update is meant to fix that Spectre vulnerability. But theoretically, that means you could probably exploit Spectre on other platforms as well via a browser using malicious JavaScript. So I expect other browser manufacturers may patch if they haven't already. Now, the practical takeaway for Apple users is pretty simple. If you use Mac OS, iOS, or Safari, you want to go get those updates immediately. If you're a normal desktop user, I highly recommend you just set your OS X or Mac OS computer to automatically download and install all updates as soon as they're available. Do the same for your iOS platform. In fact, if you want to update your phone right now, go to General and look for software updates. That's it for today's story. Thank you for watching.